You are welcome to the Working with Topologies in ArcMap and ArcCatalog series of exercises. In this exercise, I will show how to create a map topology on the example of this map drawn in meters. It has two semi-transparent layers. One of them is for land parcels, and the second one is for elements of street cover. Anyway, it is very important to be sure that no feature overlaps the other features and that there is no gap between any features that should by definition be strictly adjoining. But even if we zoom this map to any fragment, it is still good looking, and boundaries of the adjoining features seem to fully coincide. But this is only our superficial impression, we shouldn't believe in. And instead we have to check a boundary of each feature. We can do it manually, zooming to each feature and to each vertex. But this approach is impracticable and it doesn't make us sure that we have found all topology errors. However, fortunately, ArcMap and ArcCatalog provide us with a powerful tool for the automated topology control. So we'll go to ArcCatalog, and here we see the master plan geodatabase with two feature classes that are just the sources for the layers of our map. Here we'll create a new topology object with the inclusion of the both feature classes in order to find all gaps and overlaps in each individual feature class as well as in their combination. But first we need a feature dataset, because a topology can be created only in a feature dataset, and furthermore a topology must be in the same feature dataset with all feature classes participating in this topology. So we'll right-click our geodatabase, point to new, and click feature dataset. We'll name our dataset in some way, for instance street parcel, and click next. And now we'll define a coordinate system for our feature dataset. The easiest way to do this is to click the import button, navigate to our geodatabase, open it, and select one of the feature classes that are to participate in the topology, that is to be in the feature dataset, and click add. Thereby we've assigned a coordinate system of the street cover feature class to the whole feature dataset, and click next and click finish. And thus we have added a new but still empty feature dataset to our geodatabase. Then we'll go to ArcMap and close it. And now in the right hand part of ArcCatalog window, we'll select the both feature classes, then drag and drop them in the feature dataset. And then we'll right click our feature dataset and point to new. And click topology and click next. And now we'll define a cluster tolerance, that is a distance within which the program treats all vertices as coincident and snaps them together. In fact, this parameter helps us automatically not only find topology errors, but also remove the small errors within this distance. And as our map was drawn in meters, this value means 1 millimeter. This is okay. We'll click next. And now we'll define the both feature classes to participate in the topology and click next. And click next again. And now we can define the rules against which to verify the quality of our topology. We'll click the add rule button. And in the add rule window we see three pop-ups. The first and the third pop-ups contain the names of the feature classes in the topology, and the second one contains the rules of topology. Beside that, there is a textual description for rule selected and its picture. We can read this rule as features in the street cover feature class must not have gaps. We need this rule, so we'll click OK. And beside that, any feature in this feature class must not overlap any other feature of the same feature class. So we'll click the add rule button again, and in the rule pop-up we'll select the must not overlap rule and click OK. And now we'll apply the same rules for the second feature class. And beside that, any feature of any of these feature classes must not overlap features of the other feature class. And we'll add one rule more. And in the rule pop-up we'll select the must not overlap with rule and click OK and click Next and click Finish. The program is asking whether to validate our topology now, that is, whether to remove all the small errors within the cluster tolerance. We'll click Yes. Finally, we have created a new topology object that we'll use in the next exercise in order to automatically find all topology errors according to rules and other settings we've defined in this topology. Thank you for your attention.